what happens to a tank when you chrome. If the chromer's not careful, what we've had problems in the past is that when the tank gets chrome complete, this is what the inside of the tank sometimes will look like. It looks like shit.
Yeah, yeah.
So what we decided we were gonna do now, and this one's used for scrap, but what we decided we were gonna do is basically we cut the sides out like this. We cut them way larger than the chrome itself, because the chrome itself is pretty small, so we usually add about 3 or 4 inches on the side of that. And then we send these in to the chromer, and we just have them chrome these, because that way they can't really screw it up. They can't leave it into, because if they leave it in the stripper or something like that, that's what happens to this.
It just
gets ruined. So what we're doing now is we cut these out, we send the patches in to get chromed, then we can blast the inside of this. Mm-hmm. So we can make sure it's clean, we can see if there's any like cancerous stuff starting, if it's getting kind of sketchy where we start blasting in the bottom and there's a bunch of bad rust in it, then we could decide right then not to use it, versus painting it and having it 6 months later starting to leak on the guy or something.
Yeah.
So anyway, that's what
we just, and then you just weld it in. And
then what we do is, this is welded, this is like all welded and let it in. So these patches were cut out like right about here. And then I have my metal finish buddy. He basically just welds them in, then he leads them, and then metal finishes them. And this is basically what I end up with.
Just that little patch there.
What we do now is I tape this off. I grind all the chrome here to rough it up, so it's rough like this, and I put epoxy primer over the whole thing.
Right.
So that way we know the interior of the tank's really nice. It's nice and clean. We're not going to have any issues. And with the leading, what the leading does is, after we weld it, it just acts as a sealer. It's a body filler. It's an old school body filler. What they used to use lead on everything before Bondo. But it also acts as a sealer. So if there's any pinholes in the weld, the lead's going to cover it up. So that way we don't have any leaks.
Yeah.
So that's what, and that's.
And is basic. That is that my tank right there?
This one right here is yours.
Oh, it is.
So I still gotta etch it and I'll blast this
up. Yeah, man.
So we just got this done.
Oh, this one is.
So we gotta blast. I'll still blast it and clean it up a little bit before.
It needs to be blasted, ground.
Because this is just surface rust from. I mean, this is just from sitting around inside. So you gotta. And usually from the guy that does the metal work, it sits around there. So we gotta blast it. We just gotta tape it up and blast it, and then we'll epoxy primer it, and then it's ready to go. So yeah, that'll be, unless I screw it up, that'll be yours. This got pinstriped yesterday, so we got a buff, we'll still clean it off again. Yeah. And then we're waiting, actually the silk screener is coming in today, probably this afternoon, but he'll put the silk screen on right here. And this is all hand pinstriped. So this is basically, we've done all the, we put down epoxy primer first, and we put our filler primers, and then epoxy primer again as a sealer, then I put a base and clear on it. And I'm using like a PPG, it's basically like a 30-year paint. It's a high quality urethane. And it's all colored. Then after that, we color sand and buff it, so it's all smooth, then we get the pinstripe on it.
Right.
And then this one's a civilian
tank. Do you like her over the pinstripe? Or?
No. Because it's all, because originally, the problem is if you clear over this, then it just becomes, I don't know, I think it looks too new, it looks too modern, it doesn't look right. It doesn't match the rest of the bike. It looks very modern. So with the pinstripe just laid on top of the paint, it's kind of more original. It kind of has more of an original look to it. It's all dusty right now. And this is a civilian tank. So this has a flip top. The civilian tanks are different than the police. The civilian tanks have a flip top. If I got one around, here's a civilian tank here. See, so it's kind of like the cap. So all the civilian tanks, the cap stays with the tank.
Yeah.
And the police tanks are like this, and the cap, you can just take it off. I don't know yet why they did that, but that's just what they did. So.
Working, going, 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 going. All I can stand is down.
I don't know. Just thanks Mo for my ambassador.
Thanks Mo.
Yeah, thanks Cycle Garden. Okay, yeah. You built it.
There's only one place for a bike like this, and that's at the Cycle Garden, Huntington Beach. And out. That's good.